Alright guys, so picking up from last one, we're on board the Hispaniola, and we're traveling to Caribbea to sell the Dragon Diamond. Once we get here, I'll kind of lay stuff out for you, and then we can see where we go from there. I will help as much as I can explain the different things you're going to want to do and where you're going to want to go. And give you like little tips and tricks as we go through. Still can't believe we're really doing this. And then we go to night. Everybody goes to sleep. And Luna's missing. So from here... Hey, where's Luna? Alex, where'd she go? Let's go find her, Alex. There are only so many places in the ship she could be. Alright, now from here, you're going to want to really look around the ship. You're going to talk to Nash in a few minutes, but we're not going to do that right this second. You're going to come down. Let's see here. You're going to talk to the captain. Don't want to be falling asleep on the streets of Maribia. You'd wake up with all your money and most of your clothes missing. So you're going to have a lot more... pop culture references in this game than most RPGs, just purely because that's just, it was funny at the time. Alright, then you're gonna go down here, and there's your old friend Brett. When I told the captain I didn't have enough money to pay for passage, he threw me down here. Have you ever tried sleeping in a cargo hold that was packed with crates of fish? Well, let me tell you, it stinks. Oh dear, I made it funny. But yeah, I mean, you can find different people and talk to them. The main thing you're going to want to do while you're here, which I did this on the last video, is you want to talk to this guy before you leave the ship or once you get on the ship. The main reason for that is because he sells soap. This is, if I remember correctly, this is the only place in the game to buy soap. Now, soap costs 1,000 silver a piece, and they'll be used later in the game for some cutscenes that you can't get otherwise. And now you're going to talk to Nash. Alex, what are you doing awake, feeling nervous? I can't say I'm surprised. If it makes you feel better, I was also a bit nervous the first time I went to Maribia. You realize, of course, I'll strike you dead with thunder magic if you tell anyone. Luna couldn't sleep either. I offered to keep her company, but she went to the deck alone. And now you know where she's at. So now you're going to come down through here. You go back up onto the deck. Alright, now once you get here, you're going to have a cutscene. And it'll be her singing the boat song, which to me is one of the best songs in the game. I love the way her voice works with the music and the visual. I'm not going to talk over this, so I'm just going to let y'all listen to it.
Far off, hoping it will come today. shooting star. But what if that star is not to come? Will their dreams fade to nothing when the horizon darkens most? We all need to believe there is hope. Is an angel watching closely over me? Can there be a guiding light I've yet to see? I know my heart should guide me, but there's a hole within my soul. What will fill this emptiness inside of me? Am I to be satisfied without knowing? I wish then for a chance to see now all I need. Desperately. Is my star to come?
Hey, Luna, what are you? Alex, no. How long do you two gonna need to sleep? We're only a few miles away from Arabia. It's time to wake up and get some sunshine. Luna, I hope your nose is a snooze button because I'm about to jab it. Oh no, quit your moaning. Get up and scumblebutt. I sure am glad you woke me up, Luna. I was having a nightmare about a bunch of half-dressed servant girls hand-feeding me fish. Excuse me for thinking you wanted to wake up sometime this year.
Thank you.
pocket ever since the court gave it to us. Don't travel too far from Arabia. Not because I'm worried about you, because we'll need your help if another one of those monsters gets hungry. Well, here we are. I enjoyed having you on board, please. Good luck on your adventures. Does what they want, when they want, how they want. Eagle boy, Eagle! Looks like I beat those in the head. Let me tell you, it's hard to make money with this easy. There, you guys want to sit with me? Great, okay, I'll go first. We'll be back in here later. all I believe to be a fairy tale made up to placate the masses. It's not make-believe. We met with the white dragon at Calvaral. Oh, really? Did you say hi to the tooth fairy while you were there? Yeah, so you'll learn relatively quickly that there's a lot of people in the world of Lunar that don't believe in all the same stuff. I'll say it that way. You're from the village of birds? You know I have a daughter in bird. When you go back there, could you tell her that I miss her? I haven't heard from her in the longest time. You know that woman. She said not to worry and that she's doing fine. Oh, you know her. I'm so glad to hear she's doing all right. I'm indebted to all theater friends on my prayers. Don't spoil your good deeds if they are. Mel's daughter Jessica is good friends with Mia Alson, daughter of Lua Mia, who leads the magic deal. It's amazing when you consider that their personalities couldn't be any more different. That's the only thing I don't like about this gym. Dolls. In Ruby, humans and beastmen work side by side. This is the first place I've ever lived where I haven't been affected by prejudice or stereotypical thinking. Which, now there are a lot of those things in this game as well. Different prejudices, racism, and things like that in the game. But it's due to different stuff. It's not the same, I guess you'd say it's not the same type of racism that we have to deal with. Master Mill took over the town. We were the constant target of thieves and pirates. Now there's a reason that they're not mad. Master Mill is not someone who wants us off. By the way, the red chest, you have to have the thieves crest to even open, and the only way to get that is later in the game. You have to go to a different place, and want to come back home. You have to study magic to become a dragon master, Alex. Yes, you already knew this. Things strike me dead. The critter understands the language of humans. Yeah, Nall's interesting. We'll say it that way. compact version of Bane's magic field without the leader's data suit. Not to mention the altitude. Sorry, I couldn't help myself. You'll understand why he says that in a minute. There's a new fortune-telling shop on Black Rose Street being run by a magician from Bane. I heard that she's very good at peering into the future, and that she's very hot. Alex, why don't we ask her about the dragon? Maybe she'll know something. My insignificant story blessed by a thousand times over by your wondrous presence. I have a selection of many fantastic, wonderful magical items, you say. My first item is the magic toothbrush. It scrubs your teeth while you sleep and leaves them bright, not just white. I can tell you want one. You need one. And I get out, so it sounds like it would be kind of fun. Now all you're too lazy to clean your own teeth now, no brush for you. I knew she'd say no. It'll be your fault when I contract you to fight his own. Yeah, so they have some pretty decent jokes in here. Of course, you children have such wonderful dental hygiene, there's no need for my toothbrush. So yeah. And you'll talk to crazy people the whole way through this place. Black Rose Street is a place where the people of the ground can interact with the magicians of the sky. It's a doorway through which the common man can glimpse the power of man. If you ever have a question related to magic, come here and you will find the answer. Are you lost, cat? You'll find a nice home at the bottom of my stomach. Hey, I heard that voice somewhere before. I remember now. It's the old hag from Calder Isle who gave us the water cane. Oh, do you know my sister? Is she still living out in the middle of nowhere all by herself? I wish she'd come back to Black Rose Street to live with me again. But she said she loves the peace and quiet of the woods. Bah! She's just too stubborn to admit she misses me. Uniform for the guild. Magic guild? Yes, talk to the head priest at the shrine. Which shrine is that? The one for she who made our world. Oh, then you mean Althena Shrine? Why does the leader of Althena Shrine have one for the magic guild? This is something you'll find out later. Boo-hoo-hoo. This is absolutely horrible. This is a tragedy of all tragedies. I can't find my magic wig. I refuse to set foot outside this house until I once again have a natural looking head of fake hair. Most of the people who live on Black Rose Street learn to use magic in Bane. Almost everyone you will meet here has a degree from the magic guild, myself included. We were chosen to come here because our particular skills were far suited to the world of the brown dwellers. Which makes them get more and more interesting. Alright, now this shop is where you can buy a fire can. I'm going to pick up.
We seem to have guests, but I welcome those pursuing knowledge, as always. For you see, I am a student of knowledge, past, present, and future. I can foretell many things in the future. So, let's see your future. That's why you came to me today, isn't it?
No, that's not what we came. We really didn't come to learn anything in particular. We were trying to find that. Oh, really, from what I glanced at your future, child, you need my services quite desperately. So many of the questions you have about yourself are ones that I can answer. And you, Alex, you seem to become the greatest hero our world has ever known. But you are too humble to be a dragon knight. You are unwilling to choose power and glory. My fortune, lady. Licking your paws and coughing with hairballs, cat. It's an insult to think I would waste my energy looking into the future of a rodent. I'm not a cat. Alex Luna, have you finished your little city? Having lived in the desolation of Calder Isle, you two must be completely overwhelmed. I'm sure you'll adjust in time, and if you don't, I'll be that much more amused. Nash, what are you asking? What were you asking the fortune teller about? Hoping she might know a spell to cure bad hair days? You little rodent. In fact, I asked her, well, it's none of your business anyway. I know what it is. You asked her to see if there's a woman in your future. Nash wants a girlfriend. Good luck, Tiger. Yeah, they rip on Nash a lot. And it gets worse later. Much worse.
Thank you.
This is where you're going to find that note.
Meldial Kirk, Governor of Meribia. Since you're new here, I'll warn ya. If you dare to make any sort of trouble in my town, I'll pop your tiny little heads off your twiggy little necks and mount them on me trophy wall. So the way you're going to do this is the very first thing you're going to do is vigor. Just like any ball fight from here on out. So you're going to cast vigor. You'll hit. And then you're going to use the sword to thing like you know tomorrow.
I don't know, Alex. I think think she'd be just as scary as her father. Alright, now we can kind of move around in here and look around and stuff like that. I cannot remember for the life of me. There should be a chest in here somewhere. Okay, that's the other entrance to the sewers. Eventually. I have a habit of wanting to 100% these games, so... Alright, so now... Let's go talk to Ramus. And get that part done. First thing you're gonna notice about this dungeon is it's a little bit different than anything else you've been through so far. To open these bridges, you have to hit these little buttons on the wall. And as you go through, you'll start to hear, these different, get snakes, all kind of fun stuff in here. Fight as many of them as you can. You wanna level up at least level 15, maybe 16. Or you can do this. quickly. Thank you. as you're coming through here. Most of everything that you're going to fight through here is it's going to be fine, but there are actually two creatures in here that are to go to level 12. Once he's at level 12, that's his max out. He doesn't go any higher. Yeah! Just so you guys know, in just a second, I'm fixing to be going back out to go in and buy the iron armor for Alex. Do all this, but it will make your life much easier. My first playthrough, I didn't do any of this. God, 45 minutes to beat the boss of this dungeon. Thank you.
Thank you. Peace.